Hi students, this is Real Estate Design. Today's our topic is Sequential Logic Circuits, presented by Subhash Omni Devi. After completion of Sequential Logic Circuits, students will be able to explain the combinational logic, explain the difference between sequential and combinational logic. Combinational logic means that output depends only on the current input. That means the output does not depend on the past or future input. That is mean that combinational logic does not require any feedback loops. It has no memory. Then memory devices is not fixed in this circuit. This is called combinational logic. In this combinational logic only depend on the present input, it does not depend upon the past or future inputs. If suppose you are giving the input continuously means just at the same, if suppose you are giving one is present in the input means output is also having same output, one at the corresponding ones output is present in the output session, does not occur any past or future inputs. At the same time, if you change the input to 1 to 0 means at the time the output is also changed something 1 to 0 something else. Like that only we are having the input and output relationship in the combinational logic. That's why we does not have any memory devices in the combinational logic. Next one, sequential logic. Sequential logic means that output depends not only the current input but also the past values also. If for example, if we are giving the present one sinusoidal signal like that, but that signal changing the low to high means that time that output will also change. At the same time that output is consider the past input values also. If suppose past values does not change acquire, otherwise change will be low to high means that output is also made in the constant term. That means present input is change high to low, at the same time past input is changed to low to high. That's why that output is made in the constant term. That's why the sequential is only depend on the past and the present input. That's why we are having some memory devices also. That's mean it have the feedback loop and then it has some memory devices in the circuit. That is called the sequential logic. For example, design a counter. Counter is a sequential logic example. Next one, we are having the sequential circuit. In the circuit here, it is a combinational circuit. Just a combinational circuit, it's just depend only the present input and then it will produce the output. But some storage element is fixed, then next stage is given here. That next state means that the present output is given to feedback to the next input. That's why it depend on the past input also. That's why it will have sequential logic. In the combinational logic, how to modify the sequential means just add the storage element and then giving the feedback to present input to the past input. That's mean we are having like that. If this is the present output stage, this output is given back to input. That's why it will have the two inputs, present input and as well as past input. Then it will called the sequential circuit. Like that we are rearrange the combinational circuit into sequential circuits. Next one, sequential logic circuits. Remember past input and then past circuit states. That's why we are using the feedback path. Output from the system of fed back to as a new inputs. That's why we are having two inputs in the sequential logic. First one is present and the next one feedback. Output system is given to the input to the combinational logic. That's why we are having two input states, one present, other one is past. That's why two input with gate delay and wire delays. The storage elements of circuits that are capable of storing binary information, that is called memory. In the memory elements are also filled in the sequential logic. The sequential logic consists of feedback loop and then memory elements. It's the main difference between the combinational and then sequential logic. Next one, synchronous and asynchronous circuit. In the sequential circuit is classified into two types, that are synchronous and asynchronous circuit. First one, synchronous. Synchronous sequential circuit means that circuit output changes only at some discrete instance of time. These types of circuits achieving synchronization by using a timing signal called the clock. This is called the synchronous sequential circuit. This is only output changes at the some discrete instant of time. Next one, asynchronous sequential circuit. Asynchronous sequential circuit means circuit output can change at any time. It does not change, it depend upon the time, it will vary at any instant of time, clockless signals. That's why it's called the asynchronous. Synchronous and asynchronous main difference is clock and anti-clocks. Next one, synchronous sequential circuits. In the synchronous sequential circuit means we are having the synchronous circuit also. Synchronous means it only depend upon the present and past inputs, is called the sequential, and then clock signal is added, means it's a synchronous circuit. It's a combinational circuit and flip-flop a state memory. Here that memory is acting as a flip-flop. Then at the same time we are having clock signal, that's why it will act as a synchronous circuit. Here having the clock signal, so sequentially changing the output. The flip-flops receive their inputs from the combinational circuit and also from a clock signal with pulses that occur at fixed interval of time. That's why we are using the clock shown in the timing diagram. We shown the timing diagram of the clock pulses. This is the synchronous sequential circuit. After completion of the sequential circuit, the difference between the synchronous and asynchronous circuits. Thank you.